Hello, everybody. My name again is Gonzalo Vasquez, and this is the easiest way to learn Spanish with the Natural Learning System. Welcome back to my virtual classroom. You go to learn Spanish in 1, 2, and 3. I guarantee you that. So let's do it. Today we're going to talk about the Spanish alphabet. En español, el alfabeto español o el alfabeto hispano, de la lengua hispana. Once again, with the Natural Learning System, I had to tell you, in the Spanish alphabet, we do have 29 letters, because we have some letters that the English alphabet doesn't have, and we got to see it over here. Now I got to teach you two things over here, and that I got to emphasize in order for you to learn the perfect Spanish and make you easy, very easy to learn, and pay very careful attention, because this is the key characteristic of the easy learning. What I got to teach you over here, from here and in the future, is really a part of my system, NLS, Natural Learning System, that is going to make it easy going, easy learning, easy for you to understand when the person talks to you, what the person says, how to put it on the paper, how to assimilate, how to read, how to write. As usual, the first 3-4 classes is what, you know, what the most difficult is, and in this case is the only thing is going to be is just the first 2 classes, and the one already passed, the first one, that was the 5 vowels. Now we go with the consonants. That's what we go to call here, consonants, or las consonantes. This is the alphabet, el alfabeto. El alfabeto, the alphabet, is composed by the vowels and the consonants. Same thing as in English or any language. It's composed by the alphabet, by the consonants and the vowels. We already saw the vowels. I got to include the vowels here also for to give another shot. But what I got to do here, I got to teach you the name of the letter and the sound, because it's two different things, the name and the sound of each letter. That is a key characteristic for the learning system. That is what really, really make a difference in my system to teach you the perfect Spanish, the easiest way to learn. Nobody teaches you this way. We call, in other words, we call this the phonics in English. You got to use the phonics and you got to learn 1, 2, 3. And that's what I got to tell you. I got to teach you the Spanish phonics. You get that? Forget it. You got to speak better Spanish than I do. Okay, so let's do it. The first letter of the alphabet, as same thing in English, is, in English is A, in Spanish is A. I already told you that one. A. Alpha. One of the letters. A. Alpha. The name of the letter, A. The sound, A. Very easy. The next one, The name of the letter is B. B. In English is B. In Spanish is B. B. Now, what is the sound of this letter? The sound of the letter is B. B. Watch my mouth. B. 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 Bobo, bobo, bobo. Remember, b sound, sound, bobo. Has the same sound in English. But very, very, same sound. We have a lot of similarities, so you got to see. The next one will be say. In English is si. In Spanish, se. 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 This letter has two sounds. But for now, I'm going to teach you the two sounds, but I go more in detail when we go to see this specific letter individually, because that's what we're going to do individually. Okay? So, the name of the letter, el nombre de la letra, is C. One of the sounds is S. S. It's going to be similar to another letter. And the other, the main sound of this one is k, k, also close to another letter. Sound like another letter, like a K. Okay? K, k, like k, k, ka-sa. Ka-sa. Okay? Ka-sa. The name say the sound k. Ka-sa. Okay? Remember, k. And the vowel, a, k, ka, sa. Ka-sa. See how easy? Very easy. Okay, the next one will be a letter that you don't have this letter in English. And we call che. That is the name of the letter. This one is a letter. Some people teach, oh, CH. No, 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 no CH. It's CHE. That is one letter. Consider one letter in the Spanish language. And the sound of this letter is CH. 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 That's just like a, when you see, you listen to those trucks, those big trucks that they have, and they push the brakes and they ch 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 ch. That's easy. That's the nice way to remember. That's what I told to all my students. I said, when you stay in your car, driving your car, and nobody is listening to you, you have your closed windows and inside, so you can practice your ch ch. You know, that's the name of the, that's the sound of the letter. Che. Che is the name, and ch, 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 ch is the sound. So let's see. Chi, vo. Ch, ch, chi, vo. You see, the vowel is E. So, ch, chi, chi, vo. Chi, vo. Okay? Chi, vo. This is a God in English. Okay. The next letter is the. In English is the. In Spanish, the. See? Really close. Really close. And the sound, exactly the same. David, right? David. In Spanish, it's the same sound, and the name is really close. The. So, easy for you. Easy. Okay? Dedo. 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 Finger. Dedo. The next one. A. In Spanish, E, we already saw that in the vowels, E, and sounds E. The vowels, the name and the sound is exactly the same, echo, echo, same thing in English, echo. The next one is F, F, like you blow in a candle, F. F. It's close in English, also it's F. F. In English. In Spanish it's F. You put the A in front. F. Okay? Sounds faro. 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 Feo. The next one. Hey, hey, comes from here, okay, you swallow something and something went wrong and you, hey, hey, sounds, two sounds also, depending on the vowel that you have in front. And I'm going to teach you that in the future when we see that letter specifically. Sounds. And. Gato. Gato. And remember, it has another sound, that's all. Okay, sounds like Jota. We got to see it in the future. The next one in English is H. In Spanish is H. H. Like a H. H. Sneezing. H. Okay. In Spanish, this letter has no sound, no sound, you know. So actually, that was I always say, just joking with my students. I say they create this letter just to make our life a little difficult, or not only that, is actually to keep our memory really active, you know, just remembering that that one has no sound, so you don't lose your memory, you know. The chance for you to get Alzheimer's is minimum because you have to keep everything in mind. And this is one of those. Okay? H. So the sound is no sound. One example. One example. Huevo. Huevo. If I take off the H, sounds exactly, the word sounds exactly the same, huevo, but will be wrong in writing, put it on the paper, okay? Because if you go to write that, I say, okay, somebody translate egg for me, and you got to put that, you know, without the H, I got to give you zero, okay? The next one, we already saw that one, it's a vowel. E, I in English. Indio, indio. The next one will be Jota, Jota. Remember that I told you that this one has two sounds? Okay. In some part, they sound exactly the same. Jota. Jota. Julio. Julio. In English, you call J, and in Spanish, is Jota. Okay? You say July, we say Julio. Jota is the name. The sound is Julio. Julio. Okay? The next one will be ka. Ka. In English is K. In Spanish is ka. Sounds k, k. Remember that I told you that la letra C has two sounds? Okay, the other one is close to this one. That's the way this letter sound. K, k. Kiosko. Kiosko. The next letter is L. In English, L. In Spanish, L. See? Really close. A lot of similarities. So you got to learn this real fast. L. Sound, that's the name of the letter. L. Sound. Watch my mouth. Luna. Luna. Okay, the next one. This letter. You don't have that letter in English, because in English you call double L. We don't call double L, we call Elle. That is the name of the letter, Elle. Some people say Elle. Close enough. Elle. Elle. Okay? The sound of the letter is L. Like a double L, lluvia, lluvia. People say lluvia. Close enough. Once again, lluvia. Okay, lluvia. The next letter, M. M. Same thing. Close to English. In English is M. In Spanish, M. The sound, same thing as in English. M. 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 Mano. Mano. The next one. N. In English. In Spanish, N. N. Close enough. Sound, same thing as in English. N. N. Remember, the first one is M. La N is N. 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 Nada. Nothing. Nada. Nancy. The next one, you don't have this one. That's a nice one. The name of the letter is Ñe. 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 That's the name of the letter. The sound Ñe, 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 Ñe. Watch my mouth. Ñe, 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 Ñe. Ñato. 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 We call Ñato the person who has a flat nose, a short, little nose. Too little, too short. Ñato. Ñato. Remember, the name of that letter is Ñe. Okay? sound ni. Okay. Now this letter, the next one is O. In English, you call O clause. O, that's a vowel. O sounds O. Okay. So, also. Also. Next letter, P. P. It's really close to English also. In English, it's P. P. In Spanish, P. P. That's the name of the letter. Now, sounds P. You know, never change. It's not like in English that you put the PH and sounds. No. This, no matter what. P. Okay? P. P. Pato. Pato. P. P. Pato. The next one. Q. Q. Always followed by U. Always. Q. Queso. Queso. The next one. Ere. Ere. In English you call R. R. In Spanish is ere. Ere. Now, the sound of this letter, this particular letter, in the beginning, has r, r. If you have one in the middle of the word, it's got some r, 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 r. That's the sound r, 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 r. Okay? But when it's in the beginning of the word, sounds r, r. You know, in this case, rojo. See? R, r. Watch my mouth. R, r, rojo. Okay? I taught my students, once again, the same formula. Stay in the car. Drive in the car. Nobody listens to you. Nobody's by you on the traffic light. This is like you driving a motorcycle. Room, 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 room. I know for you guys it's a little difficult to ruin your tongue the way, especially with this letter. But this is a good way to practice. Run, 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 you know, motorcycle. Run, run. Or the car. Run, 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 run. Something that you keep practicing every time you stay in the traffic lane. Run, 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 run. Rojo. Rojo. Rosa. Rata. The next one. Doble R. Or we call R. R. We call this R, but actually, you don't see nothing in the dictionary than star with doble R or with R. This particular R is for words that has to be written with two R's. Like, for example, carro, 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 see, two R's over here, carro, call R, 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 because you run fast, carro, carro. If I eliminate, and this carro is a car, now, if I eliminate one of those R's, si yo le quito una R, but it's got to say caro, caro, and caro is expensive, expensive. Okay, so we know we got to talk about carro, about car, carro. Okay, but in the dictionary, you know, go to see anything that start with a double R or with R. You see it in the middle of the words, but not in the beginning. The next one will be ese. Close to English, es. Spanish, ese. Okay? Remember I told you that this one has two sounds? Okay, the other one is close to this one. The sound of the letter is s. Name ese. Sound s. Sapo. Sapo. Sí. 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 Solo. Sapo. It's a frog. Sapo. The next one will be T. Letter T. In English is T. The sound of the letter is, the name of the letter is T. The sound is T. Tapa. Tapa. Okay. The next letter is U. That's a vowel. In English, U. In Spanish, U. Uva. Uva. The next letter will be V. V. There is a difference, and here is, I want to emphasize once again, it's a difference between V and B. I heard and I was watching somebody, a video from somebody who is teaching Spanish on YouTube, saying that B and V sound the same, and with the Spanish we don't make a difference. No. Mm-mm. There's no way. There is a difference. Same thing as in English. So, the first one, this one is B. B. La van a escuchar como B larga. B de burro. This one is V in English. V in Spanish. V. La van a escuchar como V labial, la V corta, V labidental, labidental, because it's labios, labios, and dientes, labidental, okay? V de vaca, o V corta, okay? So, the sound is a V, V, vida. Vaca. That's the real sound of the letter. The next letter is W, and this is the only letter that you really got to find in the dictionary that start with W. I consider like a loner letter, because we use that letter to write foreign words, foreign names, and all this kind of stuff. But today, all the names have been popularized, English, European names, all this mix right now. So it has been coming more popular. Welter. Welter is the weight for the boxing weight. Welter. The next letter. And the name, I'm sorry, the name of the letter is W or V double, V double, or W is como la van a escuchar. It's how you got to listen. Okay? And the sound is like a, depending, is it Walter, Welter, Welter? Okay? Now, the next letter is X. X. In English is X. In Espanol, X. Same thing. We have a few words. Start. Not many. Usually, we use more in the middle of the words. In this case, and I have some different opinion, but if I got to read this in perfect Spanish, it will be Mexico, because that's the sound of the letter is X, 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 Mexico. But since this is for the country, and Mexico adopt this letter and has, I think it has to do with the Aztec, or anyway, was adopted by the Real Academy of the Language, and the sound they give it like a J sound, like a Jota. So you go to listen to Mexico, Mexico, okay. But really, the sound of the letter is X, X, X. The other letter is J. J. In English is Y. In Spanish is J. You go to listen also as a I griega. I griega. Okay. Has two sounds also. J, 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 and E. Sounds like the vowel E. It is. Okay? J, J, sounds J, J, Jojo, J, Jojo, Jojo. The next letter, and the last one, is Zeta. Zeta. The people from Spain, they call Zeta. Zeta, la Zeta. In Latin America, we call Zeta. Zeta. Okay, Gonzalo. Gonzalo. No Gonzalo. It's close to S. Close to S. S sounds more easy. If I pronounce my name with this letter, with S will be Gonzalo. If it's with Zeta, Gonzalo, Gonzalo, is a little more heavy. Z, Z, Zeta, and the sound is Z, 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 Z. Okay, like zebra, zebra. That is the alphabet in Spanish. I hope then you can keep practicing. Remember, you got to have me there 24/7. I'm Gonzalo Vasquez. I apologize for my voice is gone. And this is the easier way to learn Spanish with the natural learning system. Remember, subscribe to my channel. If you have any comment, any suggestions, feel free to contact me. You can do it. You can visit my webpage at www.buenoletsdoit.com, or email me at gonzalo@buenoletsdoit.com. Once again, if you need any kind of support, if you want any specific set of classes to be designed for your companies, for your profession, for your vacations, where you go, whatever, feel free to contact me. We can talk about, I will be able to design. That's what I do. I do design the language for the specific industry or profession. So this way is going to make it actually more easy for you to learn. Besides that, you got to have my support every time you need. If you need a writing translation, same thing, you can contact me through my webpage or my email. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. So let's do it.